In this video, I'm going to give you a checklist of things you can look for in your own forehand when you film yourself from the back. And if you're not filming yourself, you need to. Just take your phone, rest it up against the back fence, and just film yourself for 5 minutes hitting forehands. And I want you to review the footage afterwards. So get a piece of paper and I want you to write down this checklist so you can become your own coach and you can look for these things in your own forehand. Now, the first thing with Sun Wu Kwan here is notice his foot movement, that after every shot, he's bouncing up on his toes. This takes a lot of endurance and athleticism, and it's not easy to just constantly be moving your feet a lot in between your shots, but you need to. You need to have that buoyancy and that bounce to your movement. So please check to see that you are bouncing on your toes. You can even see the distance. Look at the distance between his legs, where, you know, this is his spine, but his legs are like this. We see the same thing with Djokovic, how far apart his feet are. So please start bouncing on your toes in between each shot with your feet apart. Now, the second thing is the split step. So let's look specifically here. This is actually Holger Rune, who he's rallying against. And when Holger's hitting the ball right there, notice that Kwan is going up. Watch Kwan go up with his body just as Holger's hitting the ball. That's because pros do not land their split step as the opponent hits. They actually try to be in the air. It's almost like a jump rope going under their feet and they're jumping over the rope. They actually land their split step after the opponent makes contact. That's because they're trying to synchronize when their brain reacts to where the ball is going with when their feet hit the ground. So they don't want to be landing as the opponent's hitting. They want to land after, giving their brain time to react because they want to land and then immediately be able to bounce in any direction to get into the position or out of the way of the ball. So you want to be in the air as the opponent makes contact. That is what every pro does in every situation, and you should be doing the same. The next idea, notice that the moment Kwan sees this ball coming to him, he immediately gets his chest to the side. Immediately. That before this ball, right there, the ball's bouncing. Before this ball ever bounces, we're able to see Kwan's chest. Like right there, we can start to see his chest. We can see the sun shining on his chest because of the shadow. We can see the shadow. So you need to make sure that the moment you split step, you immediately get your body to the side. He's actually turning a little past 90 degrees by the time the ball bounces. I would say his shoulders are at 110 or about 100 degrees. So really get your body turned. We can see that his hips are in this position, but his shoulders are in this position. That's because his shoulders have turned more than his hips. That's the definition of a coil that you can then uncoil. So please get your body sideways quickly. The next thing is notice he's taking the racket back with both hands as he does that. Now, he has the tip of the racket pointing forward over the net, butt cap pointing at the camera. This is what you see Kyrgios do. He's got a high back elbow and his armpit is exposed to the camera. That's the way he takes the racket back, but just get the body sideways and take the racket back with both hands. You can even see that he's loading up the weight on his back leg, ready to transfer his weight onto his front leg. You can see that back foot turn up on the toe because of the weight transfer. Now, here's the next idea. So we're working on keeping our feet wide and bouncing. We're working on the split step. We're working on early racket prep and body prep, getting that unit turn to happen the moment you see the ball coming to your forehand. Now, I want you to watch this. This is really detailed. Notice that his racket's going to go down as his left hand clears out of the way. You know, we want to take the racket back with both hands as a unit turn, but watch. As the racket drops, notice his hands separate. So the racket's going down. He's using a pre-stretch forehand where the strings are facing down with the tip of the racket pointing off to the right as a right-hander. And then we're going to see his hand come forward as the racket goes back. This is often called a lag, right? It pre-stretches the forehand and can help keep you, you know, keep your swing small and still be able to accelerate the racket beautifully. But notice his left hand clearing out of the way. Most recreational players know that the body rotating is what brings the racket through contact. So you can see he's not swinging with his arm as much. And look at his hips. See his hips turn? He's rotating his body, and the body is pulling the arm through and the racket through. But what turns the body? The front arm turns the body. You're not going to get your body and your hips to rotate if you're not utilizing this front arm and clearing it out of the way. Watch his left hand and where it goes. Here, his left hand, his front arm is right here. That's his hand. And now look at contact. This is one of the things I teach, is that you should be able to see the non-hitting hand over the non-hitting shoulder at contact. His hand has moved from one circle to the other circle. If you're not moving your hand up and across, then you're not going to be able to turn your hips. If your hand is dropping or just staying over here, you're not going to rotate, and then you're going to have to arm the ball, which is not what you want. So take the racket back with both hands, but as your racket drops, you need to be clearing that front arm out of the way. Now, when he clears that front arm out of the way and he's in the slot, it's called the slot, like this position right there where the butt cap is basically pointing at the ball, I want you to notice his strings. To me, this is the number one reason why recreational players struggle to hit topspin. If you really cannot shape the ball and dip the ball and hit a topspin lob or a cross-court passing shot, or dip the ball to someone's feet, or hit the ball really high over the net and have it safely come down in the court when you swing fast, it is because you are not closing your racket face. And it doesn't matter if you have an Eastern grip, a semi-Western, a full Western, you can close your racket face no matter the grip. When your racket face is tilted down toward the ground, that prior to contact and below contact, that is what then gets your strings to face forward consistently at contact. So many players, their racket at this point, rather than their strings being tilted down at about 45 degrees, which what we see with Quan here, most recreational players I see who struggle to hit topspin have their racket straight up and down. And their strings, if the strings were a mirror, would be facing directly off to the side. Then what happens is they swing up and through the ball because they know that low to high is the way you're going to get topspin. And then the ball just shoots over the fence. And they're like, well, swinging up doesn't work for me. And it's like, no. It's because your racket is straight up and down. You've got to make sure that prior to hitting the ball, your strings are closed. That is what allows you to swing away from the body. You can see his swing goes inside out. You see the racket tracks out away from the body, and he is spinning up the back of this ball. This ball is spinning over itself because he's going from low to high as he hits with a racket face that is directly facing Holger Rune at contact. And that's because his racket closed prior, which just with the pendulum of your arm results in the strings facing forward when you strike the ball. You can see his hips rotating, and I already mentioned it, but it's so important it requires another mention. I want you to film yourself, or if you already have footage of you hitting forehands, please look at it right after this video, and I want you to stop the video at contact. You can see this is exactly when he's hitting the ball. Notice at this point, his non-hitting hand is visible over the shoulder. I've shown you countless pros who have this look at contact from the back. This is why it's so important that you are trained in what to look for from different directions. From the back view of you filming your forehand, you need to see this hand over the non-hitting shoulder. That is what is allowing the hips to turn. So make sure that your non-hitting hand is visible over the shoulder after or at contact. I really like this finish where he's going kind of on the side of his shoulder. I teach a little bit higher in most cases for recreational players, but this is absolutely fine. You can see that back foot comes up on the toe a little bit, obviously because his hips are turning, and then he's back into position again, feet moving, and then he's got that split step. So please go out and film yourself. Go through this checklist of what we just worked on. If you need to, review this footage over and over again to make sure that you are hitting the best forehands you can. Now, the best way to practice these techniques is at home with a Topspin Pro. You can get a Topspin Pro using my link in the description. I'm also going to pin it in the first comment. I absolutely love the Topspin Pro, and I know you will too. And if you're looking for people in your local area to play matches against or practice with, or if you want to find a coach who's close to you who can help you with your game, then use my link in the description for Play Your Court. And it's playyourcourt.com/2-minute-tennis. When you use my link to sign up, you get 50% off. So go out and film yourself hitting forehands from the back and go through the checklist that you just learned. And there's no doubt you're going to gain confidence, win more matches, and play much better tennis. This is Ryan Reedy from 2MinuteTennis.net. You got this.